chapter 6 electromagnetic induction. So magnetic flux. So what is magnetic flux? Magnetic flux is a total number of magnetic lines of force crossing the surface normally. Normally means perpendicular. Let us we take this surface. Okay, so this is a surface of area A. So there is a magnetic field passing through this surface which is perpendicular to this surface. Okay, so whenever you take any surface, the surface vector, this is a surface vector n cap, is normal to this surface. Let us already I told that, let us assume that this is my hand. So the my hand has a two surface, this is a front surface and back surface. So the front surface vector will be directing in this left side and this back side surface will be directing right side. So this is a surface, the surface vector will be directing perpendicular to this, normal to this. So the magnetic field lines, what is the total magnetic flux? The total magnetic flux is a number of lines crossing the surface normally. So it is perpendicularly, how many lines are crossing this surface is called as a magnetic flux. The area vector is also normal to this. So in this case, the B and A vector are parallel to each other. So in general, we can put that the pi is a notation for magnetic flux. So pi is equal to magnetic field into area. So if the area is cross, it will be a slanting down. So like this, it is not exactly in the perpendicular. So it is in the slanting, inclined one. So you see the pen. So if the area is in this direction, so the perpendicular vector, area vector will be exactly horizontal. So if the area is slanting, the perpendicular vector is always, that is the area vector is always perpendicular to this surface. So this is a area vector n cap. So when the magnetic field lines are crossing horizontally, this area vector make an angle theta with this B vector. So this is a B, is a magnetic field is a vector, area is also a vector which makes an angle theta with B vector. So hence we can write pi, the magnetic flux is in terms of cos theta. In general we can write pi is equal to BA cos theta, that is it is a dot product B vector dot A vector. So in integral form, if you take a small surface area, that is a dA, so the total surface area which is equal to integral b dA cos theta or integral b dot dA, b vector dot dA. So again I will say that the magnetic flux means a number of lines crossing per unit area, that means in the surface normally always the magnetic lines are passing in this horizontal direction, but the surface vector is perpendicular to this, the area vector is perpendicular to this surface. So if the area is, the surface is exactly in the vertical plane, the perpendicular vector, the area vector will be a horizontal. If it is slanting, always it will be going in the perpendicular direction, normal direction. So when the normal direction, the area vector make an angle theta with B, hence we can write magnetic flux which is equal to B vector dot A vector, that is BA cos theta. So magnetic flux is a scalar quantity. Magnetic flux is a scalar quantity because it is a dot product, a scalar product, the product of two vectors which gives a scalar. Even physically we know that it is a number of magnetic field lines, so number means scalar. So only we are giving here scalar product here. So what is the SI unit of magnetic flux? SI unit of magnetic flux is pi is equal to, what is the formula? Pi is equal to BA. So Weber, Weber is a magnetic flux SI unit. So magnetic field is Tesla and area is meter square. So when 1 Weber which is equal to 1 Weber which is equal to, this is a unit, WB is equal to 1 Tesla meter square. In CGS unit, this magnetic flux is 1 Maxwell which is equal to 1 Gauss into centimeter square. Maxwell is a CGS unit of magnetic flux and Gauss is a CGS unit of magnetic field. So we can write 1 Maxwell which is equal to 1 Gauss centimeter square. So 1 max is equal to 1 gauss centimeter square. What is the relation between SI unit and CGS system? So 1 Weber is equal to 10 power 8 Maxwell. 1 Weber is equal to 10 power 8 Maxwell. When this theta, so I am saying this theta, you know, when this theta make an angle 0 with flux, that flux is called positive flux. So this in this case, so the area vector is parallel to the magnetic field vector, so the angle is 0, hence pi is equal to P, plus ba. Then when theta is 180 degree, that is minus ba, which denotes negative flux. So very clearly we have studied about magnetic flux. Magnetic flux means total number of lines of force crossing the surface normally. So magnetic field and the surface vector are normal. Okay. Then what is electromagnetic induction? So the electromagnetic induction is the phenomenon of production of induced EMF. So whenever the EMF is induced, the current will be induced. So the phenomenon of production of induced EMF due to the change in magnetic flux linked with the closed surface is called electromagnetic induction. So in simple words, we can say that whenever there is a change in magnetic flux with respect to time, the EMF will be induced. So this can be explained clearly by Faraday experiments. So the first Faraday experiment is induced EMF with stationary coil with moving magnet. So this coil is connected with galvanometer. A galvanometer is a device used to detect the current. So whenever the galvanometer needle deflected, so it denotes that there is a current in the circuit. So initially there is no battery in this circuit, so galvanometer shows zero deflection. Then the magnet north pole is moving towards the coil, so this direction is in this direction, it will shows the deflection in this direction. Galvanometer shows the deflection in this direction. That means there will be a current induced in this coil. So this shows that whenever there is a change in magnetic fields, when the bar magnet is moved, there will be a change in magnetic flux. So the galvanometer deflected, and hence we found that EMF is induced. Similarly, when the bar magnet is moving away, so it is moving towards the coil, and here it is moving away from the coil, there also there is a change in magnetic flux. So the deflection will be in the opposite sense. So here the north pole is moving away from the coil, here the north pole is moves towards the coil. In both the cases the deflection will occur, but in the moving towards the coil the deflection is in right side, in moving away from the coil the deflection will be in the left side. So this denotes that whenever there is a change in direction, my EMF direction also changes. So very simple, if you move faster, the deflection is also, magnitude also increases. So faster the flux change, larger the induced EMF. Whenever the more fluxes are changed, EMF values also increase more. So very simple, if you take the bar magnet, keep near it to the, or you keeping inside the coil or whatever it is, if the coil is, the magnetic field is at rest, there is a no deflection take place. That means there is a no EMF induced in the coil. So very simple experiment. So this experiment, Faraday's experiment denotes that whenever there is a change in magnetic flux, then only the EMF will be induced. Whenever the bar magnet is moved, then only the deflection take place, and hence the EMF induced can be concluded. But if the bar magnet is not moving, there is a no change in magnetic flux, there is a no EMF. We can do the same experiment in different way. So bar magnet kept in stationary, if you move the coil here and there, so here the velocity of the coil you kept in the trolley, so what will happen? If you move the coil towards the bar magnet or away from the bar magnet, the galvanometer shows the deflection, hence the EMF induced. So by using this Faraday's experiment, we come to the conclusion there is a loss of Faraday's, that is a Faraday's loss of electromagnetic induction. So whenever the magnetic flux linked with the closed circuit changes, and EMF, that means a current, is induced in it, which last only so as long as the change in magnetic flux take place. Very simple. Up to the, so that means the EMF is induced continuously if the continuous change in magnetic flux take place. If the magnetic flux change is stopped, the EMF is not produced. That means EMF not induced in this coil. So this is called as a electromagnetic induction. So second law says that when the magnitude of the induced EMF is equal to rate of change of magnetic flux linked with the closed surface. That means if the faster the rate of change in magnetic flux, faster the induced EMF. That means larger the induced EMF. So we can write mathematically E is equal to EMF is E is equal to d pi by dt. So this is a mathematical expression for EMF. That is a d pi by d pi is a magnetic flux. So change in magnetic flux with respect to time is a EMF. So the very important remarkable law is Lenz law. So after the discovery of the Lenz law only the Faraday's experiment is will be completely accepted, because the Lenz law states the direction of the induced EMF in such that what is the direction? It will opposes the cause which produces in it. That means the EMF is produced because of the change in magnetic flux. So once the change in magnetic flux take place, EMF induced, that induced EMF will opposes the changes in the magnetic flux. So that will take place. It opposes the change in magnetic flux. Hence we can put minus sign in this equation mathematically. So E is equal to minus d pi by dt. If there is a n number of turns, we can put E is equal to minus n d pi by dt. So very simple students, very clearly we have studied about what is magnetic flux, the number of magnetic field lines is a magnetic flux, what is the relation between the magnetic flux and the magnetic field with respect to area is pi is equal to ba in the vector form, pi is equal to b vector dot a vector, that is ba cos theta. So we have studied the SI unit of SI unit and CGS unit of the magnetic flux, and very important thing, what is electromagnetic induction? Whenever there is a change in magnetic flux, EMF induced, that will be experimentally proved by the Faraday's experiments, and we concluded with the laws, Faraday's laws of electromagnetic induction, first law, second law and Lenz law. First law states that how the EMF is induced. Second law explains about what is the magnitude of the induced EMF. Then Lenz law describes the direction of induced EMF.